Good morning, everyone, and welcome. Before we start this morning, can I just do the usual notices and ask you to make sure that your mobile phones are switched off? The second notice is in the unlikely event that the fire alarms do go off, can you just remain seated and await further instructions? Thank you.
The four elements, the fire, air, earth, and water did contest which was the strongest, noblest, and the best. Who was of greatest use and mightiest force? In placid terms, they thought now to discourse that in due order, each her turn should speak. Most
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Speech Day. This is no ordinary Speech Day, because Priorsfield is no ordinary school. We have a morning of celebration and spectacle ahead of us, and I can think of no better way to have started than that fantastic interpretation in dance and music of Adeimus, which just happens to be one of my favourite pieces. Thank you, movers and shakers, and members of the first form. That was fantastic. I'm delighted, by the way, that Wimbledon have agreed to our request to move the tournament back a week so that Speech Day no longer clashes with Ladies' Finals Day. So you can stay all afternoon if you like. Today we celebrate an incredibly wide range of talents and achievements by the girls, none of which would have been possible without the dedication and application of the whole school team. Thank you all so much for making this such a happy and purposeful place. Let me give you one example of their commitment. Many of you will know only too well of the forthcoming changes to the exam syllabuses and structure that come in next academic year. Our SLT, heads of department, and many other teachers have been working hard right from the moment that the changes were first mooted, and we were well ahead of the game in getting ready. There's always an enormous amount of work for preparing for any lesson that's taught in the classroom, and I realise that there will be a lot of additional pressure to get to grips with the changes in the coming year. And I should like to pay tribute to the commitment that all our staff have shown, and I have no doubt that they will ensure that the transition will be as seamless as possible. I'm delighted to announce that no expense has been spared, in fact, come to think of it, no expense was incurred either, in bringing to you a very special person to present our prizes today, Mrs. Roseblade. For those of you who were here last year, I dazzled you, well, dazzled might be a bit of an overstatement, with photo montages of our building development plans. This year, it's for real. The demolition gang move in on Monday. But our technology gurus will have the last word, because at the very end of today's proceedings, we will be showing a video animation of the new building. So do please stay to watch it if you haven't expired with the heat before then. We hope that the new music block will be ready for September next year, and the extended science and technology block the following January. I'd like to thank our estates committee for all their hard work in developing the building plan. It was led by Roddy Long, who has now retired from the board, but whom I'm delighted to see is here today. I'd like to place on record our thanks to Roddy for the huge contribution he has made to improving our estate during his 12 years as a governor. Thank you, Roddy. May I take this opportunity also to thank my colleagues on the Board of Governors for their hard work during the year. Not all of it has been about buildings. Probably the most important job of a board is to select a new head. And in the latter part of last year, we spent a great deal of time on that process, culminating, as you know, in the appointment of Tracy Koenig from September. There will be a number of opportunities next term for you to meet her as she takes over the reins. She has been given a very straightforward brief: to build on what has gone before and make Priorsfield even better than it is now. We will be keeping to what we're good at, finding that spark and igniting it in an environment that is happy and compassionate, with a shared sense of enthusiasm and purpose, where each and every girl is valued and cherished, and where the girls' experience is exciting, stretching, and full of opportunity. We intend to continue to attract girls with talent and potential in lots of different areas, We will not be pursuing the route of an academic hothouse. What we have here is so much better than that. Sometimes we like to do things differently, and our innovative team will no doubt continue to come up with new ideas. I'd like to share with you some examples of that through a few quotes. At the time of the eclipse earlier this year, Priorsfield sent out an announcement saying, "For the eclipse tomorrow, the school is altering the timetable and providing goggles for the girls to look at it." Another school issued a warning to pupils not to look at the eclipse for health and safety reasons. A girl who had had some difficulties at another school came here, and after just a few weeks, she said, "I love the way I can be myself at Priorsfield. I don't have to pretend to be someone I'm not. Priorsfield are happy with me the way I am." And finally, after looking round at a number of schools, the parent of a prospective pupil said, "Other schools offer a formula. Priorsfield offers a solution. There is an excitement and buzz from the girls about the work that I have not seen anywhere else." On that note, I would now like to invite the head to tell us about the excitement and buzz of the past year. Thank you.
Good morning. At this year's Founders Day, our speaker was an old girl who sits on the MCC committee. She shared her passion for cricket with us and read the words of her sporting hero, the Australian Betty Wilson, one of the greatest women cricketers of all time, who wrote, "There's no use standing there all day waiting for the ball you want to hit. There are lots of other balls that are going to come your way, so you need to learn how to hit them all." And those words took us back to the very first assembly of the school year, when we considered our resumes, our CVs, and the importance of not just building up a catalogue of experiences and accomplishments, what we can do, but of developing our personal qualities, who we are. The agenda for any good school is to prepare young people for life ahead so that they're ready for whatever is thrown at them. And that's something that certainly characterises this school, where we recognise that girls are far more than the sum of their exam results. Not every girl will be an exceptional scholar, sportswoman, musician, or artist, but each and every one of them has the capacity to become an exceptional human being. Priorsfield is about growing that potential and remembering, in Aldous Huxley's words, that there's more to life than just getting things done. A couple of years ago, an Upper Sixth leaver left us a thank you letter where she reflected on this. "You have taught me the importance of kindness, how to hold a conversation, to see the good in people, how to lose with grace and win with pride, and that you cannot always rely on technology. You have inspired me to believe I can be the best version of myself, that a bad Monday doesn't mean a bad week, and that being a woman has only advantages." In recent months, the Director General of the CBI has commented that for most bosses, qualifications are not at the top of their recruitment checklist. Instead, he said, they look for well-rounded young people with enthusiasm, creativity, and passion. Those who can think for themselves, take the initiative, and work successfully with others. Well, the Department for Education, in all its wisdom, has now seized on this and has discovered what any excellent school has always known, about the importance of developing character. Some in the world of education are now calling on Ofsted to measure character building as part of inspection, and the Secretary of State for Education has recently announced that she's offering cash prizes to schools who promote this. Well, today we're together and we're celebrating academic achievement, but we also recognise so many other qualities. There are no grades for integrity, for leadership, for looking after others, but these things are equally precious and very much a part of this school's wider definition of what it means to be successful. Congratulations to everyone who will receive an award this morning, and to many, many others who've also had a fabulous year. Looking back, we got off to a hugely busy start in the autumn with an arts festival, folk night, and a question time evening with panellists from Surrey and Manchester universities. Younger girls who were led by the drama scholars shone in the school Shakespeare Festival with a very polished professional performance of Twelfth Night. And in November, we were treated to a quite brilliant production of Beauty and the Beast. The girls then tuned their voices for a beautiful carol service and term ended with a staff panto, which I have to say will stay with me forever. In the spring term, we were dazzled by performances in house music, dance, and storytelling. Our bands and singers took to the stage alongside guest performer Beverly Craven, and believe me, PF certainly rocked. This followed a masterclass with the violinist Nicola Benedetti, which was an extraordinary evening, particularly for the two girls who played so beautifully, and we were absolutely enthralled. In March, the House Art Competition attracted over 200 entries, and the standard of the winning pieces was remarkable. Two of last year's upper sixth had work selected for exhibition at the Royal Society of British Arts annual show, with one of them winning the Art Trust Award for Most Promising Young Artist 2014. That's a huge accolade, and we were very proud of them. The term ended with a very colourful, dramatic, big event, which involved nearly 150 talented, enthusiastic girls, and we raised £20,000 for foundationary bursaries, thanks to the very generous support of parents and staff. Over Easter, the grounds were transformed as we hosted the AppArt sculpture exhibition, and this was a yet another opportunity for our own artists. We were then straight into some virtuoso performances at the summer term Classics by Candlelight evening. Music continues to go from strength to strength, and at the moment, over 40% of the school takes individual lessons. And for me, watching these girls move seamlessly as they do, and with such technical ease, between classical violin and piano, to lead vocals, drums, and electric guitar in one of the rock bands, has been a real joy to see. During the year, our scholars were poised and accomplished in public concerts in Guildford, and we were treated to some really lively tea time concerts back at school. And what always shines through is their enjoyment and their tremendous commitment to practicing, to achieving excellence. Creativity and self-expression are highly prized at this school, and every summer we look forward to the art, photography and textiles exhibitions. Once again, we could see that so much of the work on display was way beyond GCSE and A-level standard, and the technical skill, the confidence and variety was quite breathtaking. More recently, younger girls took to the stage in a very flamboyant production of Wind in the Willows. Drama is a particular passion for so many, and this year we've had our best ever Lambda results, with 50% at distinction, and six girls achieving over 90% or more which is outstanding. There have been other opportunities for pop-up theatre, the house drama competition, the RADA qualification, and we were so impressed with the GCSE and A-level practical performances. The term ended with Activities Week, and the girls walking, camping, immersing themselves in history and culture, enjoying water sports or practicing their Spanish in Granada. In true PF fashion, there's been plenty to encourage a spirit of adventure. And on the sporting front, it's been a year of some significant successes. I have to say, not least of which was winning the planning permission marathon for floodlights, which were installed in October, and they've made a huge difference. We were also very excited by the appointment of former Davis Cup captain and coach George Martin to the Tennis Academy. Our players have been on a roll with impressive individual rankings. The under-15s, with an average age of just 13, reached the final of the Surrey Schools under-18 tournament. And this week, in the UK Independent Schools Championships, our under-15 pair came sixth from nearly 80 of the top sporting schools across the country. But across so many different sports, from netball, athletics, hockey, biathlon, triathlon, rugby, golf, horse riding, cross-country riding, skiing, swimming, sailing, girls have excelled, as you'll see from the sports video later. We have some exceptionally talented sports girls, sports women, and they win and compete at club, county, national, and international level. We're very proud of each of them. But throughout the year, there have been lots of other sorts of challenges. Maths Olympiads and masterclasses, the BBC School Report, Languages Day, the University of Cambridge Maths Roadshow, wonderful junior EPQ, and our own MasterChef. National Poetry Day and Book Week was sparked some wonderful creative writing, and several girls this year have been published in young writers' anthologies. One of the first form classes published their own superb poetry collection, and others baked literary cakes, a challenge but an ingenious way of combining our two favourite school passions. But this was also the year that chess took off, with one of the six form qualifying as the Southern Counties for the Southern Counties chess mega final as the best under 18 girl in Surrey. Well, wow for that. And a younger student went on to win the under 14 All Surrey Girls Championship. And on the debating front, we put ourselves firmly on the map when we hosted 8 schools for our own challenge, welcomed 11 more to the English Speaking Union competition, and took part in the Cambridge Union debates. Individuals have represented the Surrey Air Cadets in hockey. They've taken a gold medal in a national pistol shooting competition, completed the Three Peaks Challenge in under 11 hours, performed in local music and drama competitions and festivals, joined the casts of professional theatres, and graced the stage at Sadler's Wells. The Green Power team had a very successful run, qualifying once again for the national finals at Goodwood, and our equestrian team were joint winners of the Southern Central Regional Points League 2014. In the Alan Turing code-breaking competition, which runs across the country, an upper school girl was fourth from nearly 1,000 entries. Six formers have also been setting the pace, taking Chartered Management Institute qualifications and completing Teaching English as a Foreign Language certification, as well as running their own businesses. Something which continues to grow in popularity is the Duke of Edinburgh programme, and staff were thrilled this year to join some of last year's Upper Sixth and their families as they received their gold awards at St James's Palace. So far this year, 5 girls have completed gold, 15 silver, 23 bronze, and so many more are well underway. So our focus as a school remains broad, and we're committed to an ambitious programme of clubs, activities and events. This year alone, we've ventured to Greece, Poland and Iceland. And there have been over 100 day trips, from the Houses of Parliament, Bank of England, to the Royal Opera House and the Zoological Society of London, all of them widening horizons and offering some really exciting opportunities for learning. The creative and cultural life of the school has been fed by visits to theatres, museums, galleries, trips to Stratford, Florence, Seville, and by an impressive range of sixth form lectures. Last November, Sir Ranulph Fiennes delivered a fabulous Huxley lecture, and David Starkey is booked for the next one to speak on the Magna Carta. With changes to GCSE, A-level and league tables, as Richard Green has said, there's no doubt that big challenges lie ahead. Sadly, though, many schools are now under pressure to narrow down the choice of subjects they provide. Instead of offering breadth and letting pupils play to their strengths, they are steering them towards a small core of subjects which will earn the schools more points in the newly configured performance measures. Arts subjects are the casualties. And as a nation, we're in danger of squandering the extraordinary capacities that young people have. Their imagination, creativity, and ability to think freely, what W.B. Yeats called the best part of the mind. These capabilities enrich our humanity. They're vital to living happy, fulfilled lives, but they also tap into a particularly successful strand in our national economy, so short-sighted on so many levels. I'm proud that as a school, we haven't allowed wider educational diktats to crush the life, the innovation, the joy out of the education we provide here. And we continue to resist becoming formulaic and refuse to churn out standardised products or to reward conformity. Instead, we underwrite each year our commitment to an all-round experience which focuses on the growth of the whole person. On speech day and every other day, we celebrate achievements that are underpinned by our broad, balanced curriculum. One of the ways in which we do this is to encourage links with universities and the wider community. This year, girls have attended the flagship Royal Institution Christmas Lecture. They've taken part in a global business enterprise challenge. They've gained places on masterclasses at Corpus Christi, Cambridge, in English, biomedical sciences and psychology. They've visited research labs at Surrey University and attended lectures at the Institute of Education. Others have entered the BAFTA Young Game Designers competition or taken part in Royal Academy workshops. We also had a winner for the eighth year running in the Society of Chemical Industries Best Sixth Form Chemist of the Year Awards at Reading University. At the same time, a team from the lower sixth saw off some very stiff competition to come third in that society's UK Schools Analyst competition. And there have been some significant charity initiatives. Girls have cycled for the RNLI, supported Help for Heroes, Red Nose Day, Macmillan Cancer Charities. They've taken part in the Brighton Colour Run and campaigned to save the rhino. Between us as a school, we've raised £8,000 over the year. The sixth form Bangladesh embroidery team produced a superb PF cookbook. We raised £2,000 together from the Feet Forward for the foundation. And once again, queuing at the ice cream van on a Friday has earned us £100 a month, again for the foundation. The first forms, you'll remember, raised money to set up a tap in a Nepalese village, and the mountain range of loose change, which we created, along with cake sales, raised a further £1,500 for the devastating earthquake appeal. We've done all of that together as a community, and of course that makes it very hard each year to say goodbye to those who are leaving us. The Upper Sixth has been an absolutely wonderful year, full of personality and talent. We all loved your final day. Beach volleyball in the staff room and Bob Marley at full volume, what could be better? You've been a positive force for good and now joined the ranks of distinguished old girls, fully equipped for the next step and ready to do something wonderful with your lives. The boarding passes you created on that last day say it all. This ticket will take you anywhere, and I will treasure the book you made for me. Good luck to the fifth form with GCSE results. You've also been a year full of personality and energy. You've given a lot and deserve to do well. We're looking forward to an impressive lower sixth in September. One of you gave me a plate decorated with a unicorn and the words, "Those who don't believe in magic will never find it." Well, I hope you will all find some. Potential has to be encouraged, and we're so lucky to have outstanding teachers who do so much to shape the experience of school life. The writer and artist John Ruskin said that when love and skill work together, we can expect a masterpiece. I feel privileged to have led and worked with such a passionate, talented team, and I thank them all for their support over the years. Today, we're saying goodbye to a few staff. Pam Edworthy, who retires after 13 years at Priorsfield, was here first as head of maths and then as head of learning support. Caring, patient, always the first in to bat for the girls, she's made a significant difference to the lives of many and will be missed. Andy Ruane, talented chemist, is heading off after 3 years for new adventures teaching in Singapore. He's thrown himself into the life of Priorsfield, and his contribution to Bronze D of E particularly has been invaluable. As head of history, Val Burnett has been dedicated to getting the best out of each girl she's taught, and in just 2 years has made her mark with characteristic drive and passion. She is moving with her family to Somerset. And Lucy Halcrow, who's also moving on into the world of professional theatre after 4 years. She's brought so much to drama in and out of the classroom and has been a dynamic head of house. Sue Holmes has taught business studies, economics and history of art over the past 19 years. Her A-level students have enjoyed and benefited from her subject expertise, support and the confidence she has instilled in them. Thank you, Sue, for those many years. Olive Maggs, also teaching history of art, joined us for a year along with John Page, who's taught Latin. Thank you both. But we're supported in all we do by the tremendous skill and dedication of our support teams. And today we're also saying goodbye to two key members. Wendy Hilliam has been our librarian for 12 years and perhaps has been its most treasured resource. A huge influence on our reading habits, her reach has extended far beyond the library shelves and into all aspects of school life. And Anne Robinson, my amazing PA. At times, her office has been like Heathrow flight control on a bad day, but in her calm, professional way, she's brushed difficulties aside, which usually means me, and she's ensured that all of those planes have landed safely. She's been a hugely important part of the school for 8 years. Each of you has made a special contribution to the success of our school. You leave with our sincere thanks and best wishes for the future. As always, there are other people to thank. the senior leadership team for the marvellous job they do, for their insight, their good humour and their integrity. They've been an absolute pleasure and delight to work with, and I thank them. Our governors, who are so generous with their time and skills, they have a clear vision for this school, are committed to its success, and do a wonderful job of protecting its values. The trustees of the foundation for their drive and enthusiasm in leading the development of what's become a very important aspect of the school. In addition to supporting bursaries this year, the foundation has provided £10,000 for new lighting in the hall, and this will transform what we can do with the school productions. Our tireless PSA for everything they do for us. And finally, the many individual parents who've supported in so many ways. Well, the work goes on over the summer, and the refurbishment of the junior boarding house will be completed. And of course, as we've heard, it'll be all systems go with the new music, science and technology building, which is incredibly exciting. There's a powerful momentum and we don't stop. I've had an incredibly happy and rewarding 9 years, and they've sped by, possibly because so much has happened. There is never a dull moment at Priorsfield. And often it's easy as a head to see things in measurable terms, pupil numbers, exam results, new buildings. But if that's all the job is, then it becomes a mechanical activity. The real joy comes from seeing young people grow and do the most extraordinary things. Teenagers can get it wrong. That's on the growing up job description. But they also get a huge amount right and are inspiring to be around. In recent weeks, I've had my last morning breaks with tutor groups, taken my last assembly, enjoyed my last school day and sports day, and I don't think I can describe what those things have meant to me. But a final word for the girls. However much lost property you generate, however noisy above my office, however messy in the dining room, however short those rolled up skirts, I am proud of you and I will miss you. Thank you for your warmth, your sense of fun, your generosity, and for rising to whatever challenges we've thrown your way. I've really treasured those qualities. A couple of years ago, my 9-year-old niece dragged me onto the trampoline in her garden. And as I was lurching from side to side, I got a little wistful and I said, oh, 10 years time, you won't want to be doing this with me. You'll be out with your friends partying. She shrugged and said, Auntie Julie, in 10 years time, you'll be way too old to do this anyway. At which point, the word retirement floated into my mind. And since then, I've been regaled, as you can imagine, with endless stories from recently retired heads. One told me he'd had a particular nightmare with a parent who'd spent years glowering at him throughout his time at school. As he was about to leave, he was astonished to hear her say, "Your successor won't be as good as you've been." He was secretly very pleased to hear this, but said modestly, "Oh no, I'm sure you're wrong about that." "No, she's not," she continued. "No, I'm not," she continued. "My family have seen 4 heads at this school, and each one's been worse than the one before." My speech on this day always seems to write itself. The narrative is already there. The girls' achievements, their efforts, their enthusiasm for whatever important causes make up the story each year. All it needs is a beginning and now an end. T.S. Eliot wrote that to make an end is to make a beginning, and that the end is where we start from. As those of us who are leaving now contemplate with mixed emotions our new beginnings, I'd like to end with something an old girl wrote to current girls when we celebrated the school's 110th anniversary. You are the inheritors. Yours is the baton now. What will you do with it? Thank you. I wish Priorsfield and each of you all the love, happiness, and success in the world.
Now here you go again, you say you want your freedom. Well, who am I to keep you down? Well, it's only right that you should play the way you feel it. But listen carefully to the sound of your loneliness, like a heartbeat drives you mad in the stillness of remembering what you had and what you lost and what you had.
We commence the distribution of prizes for the year 2015. With our subject prizes, Anna Blades is awarded mathematics and chemistry. The prize for further mathematics and photography goes to Jane Shear. Rebecca Gwither wins the prize for English and for drama. The History and Religious Studies prizes are awarded to Rosie Stocks.
Amelia Bell wins the Modern Languages Prize. And Food, Nutrition and Health goes to Catherine Goff. Charlotte Inskip wins the Biology Prize. The Prize for Business Studies and Economics is awarded to Karima Lawal. And the Prize for Politics to Majola Lawal. Hannah Knights wins the prize for Ward Needham Geography and also the Physical Education Award. The Textiles Prize is awarded to Jocelyn Fink. The Art Cup and the Prize for Physics is awarded to Cindy Yu. And the History of Art Prize for Catherine Williams. Emily Armstrong wins the Donna Coe Cup for ICT. The Psychology Prize to Leonie Collinson. And the Technology Prize is shared between Natasha Bierman and Charlotte Roberts.
Thank you.
And now our school awards. The Shaw Dancy Instrumental Cup is won by Holly James. Lydia Jarvis wins the Gwendolyn Sparks Singing Cup. The Jenkins Prize for Performance goes to Alice White. The Bork Award for Achievement in the Arts to Helena Trail. Eleanor Shaw wins the Caitlin McConnell Cup for Creative Writing. And the Julia Huxley Award for Love of Literature goes to Megan Saunders-Smith. The Public Speaking Cup has been won by Alice Barden. And the prize for contribution to student voice is shared by Rosalind Froman and Karima Lawal. The Lunnon Cup for Independence goes to Amy Newell. The June Darling Duke of Edinburgh Prize to Alice Russell. Hannah Knights wins the Games Captain Prize and shares the Roberts Physical Education Trophy with Kelly McCall, Polly Morganti, and Grace Richardson. Burton Brown Award for Sporting Achievement goes to Liliella Harland Fairweather. The Dimitriadi Cup for Tennis to Isabella Tarrant. And the long vase, also for tennis, Philippa Williams. Alex Lucy wins the Rizan Award for Support in the Sixth Form and also the Chairman's Prize. Sister Duff Cup for Service in Junior Boarding for Precious Williams. The Nicolette Gunn Junior Cup for Effort in Modern Foreign Languages is shared by Kyra Krause and Hazel Marshall. Holly Denham wins the Adesia Cup for Excellence in Food and Nutrition at GCSE. The award for Junior EPQ goes to Hannah Crosby. The Forrester Cup for All-Round Junior Achievement is won by Rebecca Haynes. And the award for Senior Achievement, Rosie Stocks. Rebecca Gwither wins the Yamamoto Cup for service to the school. Our head girls' prize, Kelly McCall. And the Deputy Head Girls Prize is shared between Anna Blades, Alex Lucy, and Holly Morganti. And I now have great pleasure in introducing our new head girl for next year, Kesney Boone. And her deputy head girls, Emma Cull, Genevieve Liebus, and Victoria Whitmarsh. And now our year group prizes. In the first form, prizes for achievement are awarded to Daisy Fletcher, Cariella Keane, Gemma Liebus, Evelyn McCackerty, Lois Morgan, and Zella Smith. Prize for commitment, Daisy Evans, Esme Hall, Mavanwi Jones, Ella Parker, Jessica Sim, and Imogen Wareham. Prize for Progress, Georgia Denton, Poppy Edmonds, Holly Rose Harland Fairweather, Emma Hutchings, Jessica Leach, and Eloise Naveen. In the second form, prizes for achievement, Anna Demonock, Matilda Cattell, Jessica Lafan, Emily Saunders, and Poppy Wagerfield. Prize for commitment, Natasha Coxedge, Saffron Gomes, Manushka Helica, Imogen Henderson, Darcy O'Hanlon, and Sophie Summers. Prize for progress, Bridie Ault, Natasha Brooks, Imogen Garthwaite, Amelia Hawes, Charlotte Lane, and Patricia Lee. In the third form, prize for achievement, Natasha Barclay White, Rebecca Haynes, Hannah Mohammed, Martha Simmons, and Megan Wood. The prize for commitment, Hannah Crosby, Kyra Krause, Beatrice Dando, Charlotte DeRuig, and Catherine Leach. Prize for progress, Maya Hallam, Annabelle Scott, Madeline Teasdale, Rebecca Vidalow, Emma White, and Molly Wilson. In the fourth form, prize for achievement, Michaela Holmes, Emily McEwen, Abigail Rutherford, Alexandra Shaw, and Maya Tanfield. Prize for commitment, Emma Aldred, Victoria Archer, Lauren Gomes, Alice Handley, Verity McPhail, and Beata Veyermeyer. The prizes for progress, Maddie Boone, Esther Finley, Phoebe Francis, Annalie Noakes, and Eleanor Wilson. In our fifth form, prizes for achievement, Lotus Jiang, Lara Martin, Alicia Newell, Laura Parison, Olivia Pollard, Megan Saunders-Smith, and Georgina Savage. And prize for commitment, Kathleen Badenheisen, Grace Carey, Lydia Ferguson, Alexandra Hardy, Chloe Mayhead, Jemima Piers, Eleanor Shaw, and Darcy Strafford Taylor. Prize for Progress, Phoebe Clayton, Lucy Collins, Jade Herring, Lydia Morgan, Hannah Stiles. Our lower sixth, prizes for achievement, for Maggie Hudson, Saskia Lawrence, Genevieve Libas, and Georgia Thorpe. Prize for commitment, Lucy Bartlett, Olivia Clegg, Imogen Culshaw, Oluwatoyin Dairo, and Amelia Hallett. And prizes for progress, Megan Grossman, Emma Handley, Phoebe Pickard-Price, Isabel Pitts, and Madeline Simmons.
When the time came for me to prepare my speech, I felt the best idea would be to turn to my friends for the help and support which we have always offered to one another. We all came to the same conclusion that our school motto, "We live by admiration, hope, and love," is truly embedded in every aspect of Prizefield life. Our school is a unique place which concentrates on the development of each individual girl, preparing her to face real life experiences. We are all different, and the teachers here recognize that. They help us to create our own identity and to embrace the various quirks and abilities that distinguish us from others. For all the girls here today, our time at school is limited. We only have one chance to make it worthwhile and to leave something valuable of ourselves behind. Not all of us are going to be rocket scientists, favorite sports stars, or talented musicians, but we are all called upon to be the best that we can be in our everyday lives, because we have the power to make the decision to be better today than we were yesterday. So my advice is to use every opportunity that PF offers. Have fun, but above all, be yourself. Throughout our 7 years here, we have come across many people who have left their mark on our lives. Today is our chance to thank all the staff that have helped shape our lives and our characters. Few people have that rare talent to build in others a sense of self-worth, of dignity, and of confidence. You have encouraged us with the love and knowledge over the years and have watched us grow. It is now time for us to move on. We appreciate everything that you have done and will always remember the happy and easy manner in which you did it. We say farewell to Mrs. Roseblade today. Her influence and great leadership has created the school that we have today. Her warmth and belief in school community is reflected in all our smiles. It has been a privilege to be part of a year group as talented and as full of zest as the Upper Sixth. We have spent some good years together, and some of the very best times we've had have been spent within Prizefield's walls. We have laughed together, cried together, shared secrets, and above all, stuck together, no matter what. We have all grown. We hope we have made our mark on the school and on one another's lives. Thank you to every one of you for adding value to my years here. To my three deputies, Holly, Alex, and Anna, my partners in crime, without your support, this year would not have been half as successful. At the end of our journey, when we are left to determine whether we have truly left something of ourselves behind, we do so not by counting the number of trophies, medals, and awards, but by counting the true friends we have gained along the way. Someone once said, "The greatest journeys in life begin with the smallest steps." And my adventure began with the first small step through Prizefield's doors. That step has proved to be my greatest and wisest, as it led me into an extraordinary school where my journey of self-discovery and self-development began. This has been a very difficult speech to make, as I now have to say goodbye to the home and family that is this school. Thank you. You have helped shape me into who I am today. There is no place quite like Prizefield. Please can everyone stand and join me in singing the school hymn.
Just in case you thought we might have forgotten to say goodbye and thank you to Julie Roseblade, fear not. Before we move to the final music, I want to say a few words of introduction and introduce Moran. For the last 9 years, Julie has been handing out praise, and none so more so than today. It's now our turn to turn the tables on her. So may I invite, firstly, Moran Kingsbury, who's chair of PSA, to make a presentation.
As we all know, Priorsfield's an amazing place, and over the last 9 years, it's been led by an amazing person, Mrs. Julie Roseblade. So I'd like Julie to accept this gift from the parents, the PSA, and the class reps. Thank you for all you've done for the school.
We've had 9 amazing years. The numbers are up by over 50%, yet we've not lost the Priorsfield magic, however you define it, and we now have our own unicorn. At the last inspection, we had the best possible result, excellent on every count. The foundation has been created. It's now supporting several girls who wouldn't otherwise have had the opportunity of experiencing a PF education. And there have been, if we heard some of that today, some remarkable achievements by the girls throughout the years, not only in the exam results in university places, but in art, music, drama, sport, with many performing at county, national, and even international level. Julie, you have been, and still are, a truly inspirational head. You've inspired the girls to achieve many great things, giving them the self-confidence not only to succeed, but often to excel, very often in areas they hadn't expected, and to be worthy citizens of the world. You've inspired your team of teachers and all of the staff to give of their all for the girls' benefit, always aiming really high, pulling out all the stops and reaching for the stars. You've inspired parents to put their trust in you and your colleagues, and given many parents reassurance, particularly through some tricky moments. And you've inspired the governors to support you as best we could in developing the school to the position it's in today. I know that you would be the first to say that the school's achievements have been as a result of the whole team's efforts. But every team needs a leader, and you have provided outstanding leadership throughout your time here. The girls have always come first for you. Through that, their successes have been your reward too, and you can look back with justifiable pride at a job superbly done. For all this, we are truly grateful. As a lasting memento of Julie's time with us, we have commissioned a portrait of her, which will adorn a wall of the school for eternity, perhaps. It seemed appropriate that we should choose as the artist a painter with a close association with the school, Daisy Cox, who left us last year. You will have an opportunity, if you wish, after the proceedings today, the portrait is in the MPR above there, or in due course when it is hanging on one of the school walls. And I'm sure Daisy will be very happy to take commissions for any loved ones you may wish to commit to canvas. It is quite outstanding, ladies and gentlemen, an 19-year-old artist who have done a painting of such quality. I do urge you to see it. As you know, and as we've heard earlier on as well, the school's motto, we live by admiration, hope, and love. Julie, you've embodied that in everything you've done. We're full of admiration of your achievements and of the way in which you've gone about realizing your ambitions for the school. You've given hope and self-belief to so many girls and parents, and you have clearly loved your time here, and we have loved having you. A few words, if I may, for parents. Many, many of you will have your own very special reasons for being grateful to Julie. And there are 3 C's which I think you ought to bear in mind. The first C is her commitment. She's always put the girls first, looking to do what is best for them. She has devoted herself wholeheartedly throughout her time with us. The second C is her consummate professionalism and her calmness, earning the respect of all and giving appropriate advice to people whenever problems have cropped up. And the third sort of C is her kindness. always a compassionate ear for parents, staff, and the girls, picking people up gently when they missed the mark the first time to enable them to fly high again next time. In the words of a parent and echoed by many in their own way, Priorsfield has given my daughter more than I could ever have imagined. Some words for the girls. Mrs. Rosemaid is a superb role model. She's shown you that you don't have to have sharp elbows to succeed, that respect for others is paramount, and that encouragement reaps rewards for all. If you can have just a fraction of those attributes, you will have succeeded. And finally, before I invite Julie on stage for the last presentation, let me say that today is, of course, tinged with sadness as we come towards the end of a wonderful era. We are going to miss you a lot, but your legacy is a school that is thriving on all fronts and, above all, is continuing to fulfill the objectives which Julia Huxley set out over 100 years ago. Thank you from the bottom of our hearts, and we wish you well in everything you do in the future. Could I invite you to step up here for a minute? I'm going to give you a bunch of flowers.
What about sunrise? What about rain? What about all the things that you said we were to gain? What about killing fields? Is there a time? What about all the things that you said were yours and mine? Did you ever stop to notice all the blood that shed before? Did you ever stop to notice this crying earth, this weeping shores? Did you ever stop to notice all the change?